today's daily rehab is about preparation for pressing and pulling. So when you have a pressing like a chest day or a pulling like a back day, I'm going to give you a few rehab exercises that you can put in beforehand to help you out. So the first one I want you to work on is pressing. Now, when you're doing a bench press, a dumbbell press, or push-ups, like a pressing movement, it's really good to do a single arm scapular press as your preparation or your warm-up exercise, okay? So you would go into a four-point position like this, okay? Now, when you're doing a one-arm press, make sure your elbow is rotated forward, so externally rotated in the shoulder, and your body is square. So I like putting one hand behind my back to remind me that I've got to keep my core on, and I want you to go down into retraction. So I'm going to retraction the shoulder blade and then pressing into protraction with the scapula, so my body comes up, my hand goes forward. Now, when I do this, if I'm externally rotated, all my delt and rotator cuff are on, okay, which is really good isometric loading for here, but I'm doing the dynamic work with the shoulder blade. So I'm trying to warm up mostly my serratus anterior and get my rotator cuff prepped, ready for the press movement. So I'm prepping for this press movement. I'm trying to wake up all the muscles around my shoulder and in my scapula. So when I do a big press movement where I use my pecs and my triceps mostly and delt, all the other little postural muscles that you need to support that mechanism are on and not asleep. Okay, so it's a really important one for you to do, and that's a closed chain. But then we need to go to open chain, especially if you're doing a bench press or a dumbbell press. Now, if you're doing push-ups, that may suffice. However, I would also try and practice making sure your scapula is moving. You're warming up that neuroprogramming to get the movement correct. So when you are pressing, you're getting the right movement of the scapula. Okay, so it's very important that you're practicing the movement, not just trying to strengthen. Okay, so what I would do, I'd go from a one-arm press on the floor, so scapular press, to a basically an open chain, like a dumbbell press, but in standing. So here, I've got some resistance load. So I've got some load to help trigger me to get the muscles firing, but there's not so much load that I'm gonna fatigue, okay? So in this position, I can go from a full retracted position, like on a bench press, and then push forward, making sure like I'll do a dumbbell press or a push-up, and then make sure I follow through with my scapular protraction, so I'm using my serratus anterior. Okay. And when you return, obviously it's retraction first and then your elbow. So make sure you don't lead with the shoulder. Okay, lead with the hand, make sure you follow up with the shoulder. And then at this point here, don't bend at that point there. Okay, you're going to be too vulnerable. You need to retract and then come back with the elbow, horizontal extension. So horizontal flexion first, so pushing forward, and then protraction, then retraction, and come back. And you just got to think hand or elbow, shoulder, shoulder, elbow, hand. So it's just the reverse. And just practicing that neuroprogramming will get you right position, and the resistance will give you the activation. So when I go into a press movement, things are working properly. So that's your press one. Now your pulling is a little bit different with closed chain, open chain. It's very easy to do closed chain prep work when you're doing pressing, okay? But it's harder to do it pulling, all right? Obviously, it's not as essential to do closed chain pulling that is to do closed chain pressing, because you're more vulnerable on a press than a pull. But what I would do, I'd probably start with an open chain scapular work first. It's a lot easier, okay? So the open chain work will be sort of the same, pulling back. So like when I was on the floor doing a press, now I'm doing a pull. I'm just doing scapular protraction and scapular retraction. But on this way, obviously the protraction is the eccentric phase and the retraction is the contractile phase. Now, make sure your brain wants to bend your elbow, wants to do a pull. So keep the elbow straight, okay? Externally rotate into here and then pull through there. Obviously you don't get as much switch on in the shoulder joint, but like I said, it's more important that you get your rotator cuff fired up for a press movement than it is for a pull movement, okay? A lot more vulnerable doing a press movement. So that is really nice. Now you can then load that into the normal movement you do in a seated row or a cable row, so, or a dumbbell row. So you now go, okay, shoulder blade, and then pull through. Now you can vary this, as far as where the elbow is. So you can go pull through, straight through here, okay, like a close row, making sure you return the arm before you return the shoulder. Or you can go a high row, okay, so you can go shoulder blade and then come out with the elbow out here. Make sure you keep your shoulder blade back before the arm goes back and then return the shoulder. So again, you think shoulder blade, arm, arm, shoulder blade. All right, so there's your pull. So both those open chain work. So in that regards, you could try a closed chain. So thinking closed chain, how am I gonna do that? Not too much load. So what you do, and this also doubles up as a really good way for you to correct your pull up. Okay, so I would use a really heavy power band to assist you with the pull up. And this is really good for someone like me who's not very strong in the pull up position, to help me get my form, otherwise I'm always struggling. So you could use, if you're strong enough to do more chin-ups or pull-ups, you could use this as a warm-up tool to try and get your form correct and make sure you get that programming, that neural stuff going before you load yourself up. Very similar to doing a machine one with the assistance, but this is gradual, so it's a little bit different. So what I would do is come up in here and put one foot in this, stretch it down. So this is now gonna spring me up, okay? So I can get my hand position correct, and what I can work on is pulling my shoulder blades into that downward position first, okay? So the depression, and then the pull, making sure I've got a good squeeze at the top, and then a real slow eccentric with the arms, and then the shoulder blades at the end. So it's shoulder blades, arms, arms, shoulder blades. So you can really perfect your pull-up position, okay? So use that as your warm-up, but also use it if you're not very strong to pull up to try and get that going. See you next week.